Okay, so our next concept is, and this you can say is our first concept from this chapter calculus. Till now we were discussing some of the basic concepts that we will be needed throughout this chapter. We have learned how to draw graph of different type of function, and we have seen how to do graphical transformation. So now our next topic is this limits. Okay, this limit is very, very important if you want to understand the other the next two topics, continuity and differentiability. So the idea of limit I will explain with the help of one basic example. Suppose if fx is x square minus 4 by x minus 2, then as you can see that this function is clearly not defined when this denominator becomes 0, that is when x is equal to 2. Okay, when x is equal to 2, then you will get 2 minus 2 0 in denominator, and therefore at 2 this function is not defined. Okay, but if we want to check the behavior of this function when x is close to 2, okay, then we use this concept of limit. At 2 the function is not defined, but when x is slightly greater than 2 or slightly less than 2, then this function is defined. Okay, so we want to find the value of this function f of x when x is very close to 2, then we need the concept of this limit. Okay, now one important thing, suppose if we want to approach to this point 2, okay, first of all, if we want to check the behavior of this function, then we write this thing as limit x tending to 2 f of x, and this will mean that x is approaching to 2. Okay, always remember that x is not equal to 2, because when x is 2 then the function is not defined. Okay, if we write limit x tending to a, then it clearly means that x is not equal to a. Okay, x is either slightly less than a or slightly greater than a. So if I am writing x tending to 2, then it means x is very close to 2, but there are two possibilities. X can approach to 2 either from this left side. In that case the value of x will be very close to 2 but always less than 2, numbers like 1.9, 1.99 and so on. So this thing is written as x tending to 2 minus, means we are approaching to 2 from left side. Okay, and second possibility is that we are approaching to 2 from right side. So in that case the value of x will be very close to 2 but always greater than 2, numbers like 2.1, 2.001 and so on. So this thing is written as x tending to 2 plus. Okay, x tending to 2 minus means x is approaching to 2 from left side, which means x is very close to 2 but always less than 2, and x tending to 2 plus, this will mean that x is approaching to 2 but from right side, meaning that the value of x is very close to 2 but always greater than 2. Okay, so now we are going to talk about these two things, right hand limit and left hand limit. What is this right hand limit and what is left hand limit? So suppose if x is approaching to 2 from right side, okay, so this we will write as limit x as x tending to 2 plus. So these are the values of x. X is 2.1, 2.01 and so on. So now we are going to see what is the corresponding value of y from here. Okay, what are the corresponding value of y for different value of x? So as you can see that this function fx is x square minus 4 by x minus 2. This can be written as x minus 2 x plus 2 divided by x minus 2. Now remember that when x is not equal to 2, then you can cancel these two, because then in that case these two will be non-zero quantity and it can be cancelled. But you have to write here that x is not equal to 2. So this means your function basically is y equals to x plus 2, where x is not equal to 2. Okay, remember that this condition is very, very important. If I don't write this, then these two functions are not same. Okay, this function x square minus 4 by x minus 2 and y equals to x plus 2, these two are different functions. The reason is that this function is defined for all the values of x, whereas this one is not defined when x is equal to 2. So you have to write here that x is not equal to 2. Now these two functions are exactly same. So now for different value of x, what are the corresponding value of y? So if x is 2.1, the value of y will be 2.1 plus 2, so this will give us 4.1. Similarly, when x is 2.01, then value of y will be 2.01 plus 2, So this is going to give us 4.01, and you can see that these will be the corresponding value of y for these given value of x, right? So from this table you can easily see that when x is approaching close to 2, okay, this number is very, very close to 2, then you can see that the value of y is approaching to a number close to 4. Okay, when x is approaching to 2, y is approaching to 4. So in mathematics this thing is written as limit x tending to 2 plus means we are approaching to 2 from right side. So limit x tending to 2 plus f of x is 4, because when x is approaching to 2 from right side, the value of y is approaching to 4. Now this is nothing but your right hand limit. Right hand limit means x is approaching to this fixed number 2 from right side. Okay, so and the meaning of this statement is, okay, if we are writing this thing, then the meaning of this thing is read as when x is approaching to 2 from right side, the value of y is approaching to 4. Remember that neither x is equal to 2 nor y is equal to 4. Okay, x is very close to 2 and y is very close to 4. So this was all about right hand limit. Now we are in a position to talk about left hand limit. Left hand limit means x is approaching to 2 from left side. Okay, meaning that the value of x is very close to 2, but x is always less than 2. So now what will happen? We have again the function is same, y equals to x plus 2, x not equal to 2. So when x is 1.9, you can see that the value of y will be 1.9 plus 2. This will give us 3.9. When x is 1.99, then the value of y will be 1.99 plus 2. So this will be 3.99. Similarly, you can see that these are the corresponding value of y for the given value of x. Okay. So now again from this table you can make one very interesting observation, that when x is approaching to 2 from left side, okay, when x is very close to 2, then you can see that the value of y is very close to 4. Okay, 3.99 is very close to 4. So this you can write as limit x tending to 2 minus fx is 4. Okay. And again remember that neither x is equal to 2. The whole point of learning this limit is that at this point the function was not defined, and we wanted to see the behavior of this function fx when x is close to this number 2. So if I am writing limit x tending to 2 minus f of x equals to 4, so this means neither x is equal to 2 nor y is equal to 4. When x is approaching to 2, y is approaching to 4. When x is very close to 2, y is very close to 4. Okay, and this thing is called left hand limit. If x is approaching to 2 from left side, then it will be left hand limit. If it is approaching to 2 from right side, then it will be right hand limit. Now next comes existence of limit. This is a very, very important concept. Suppose if limit x tending to a minus f of x, okay, this is your left hand limit. So limit x tending to a minus f of x is equal to limit x tending to a plus f of x, meaning that left hand limit is equal to right hand limit. If these two limits are same, okay, the value of limit that you are getting when x is approaching to a from left side is same as the value of fx when x is approaching to a from right side. So if these two limits are same, then we say that limit x tending to a f of x exists. Okay, and say the value of these two are same and this is equal to some number l. So then we will say that this limit exists, and the value of limit is this number l. So this is a very, very important point. If the value of left hand and right hand limit are same, then we say that limit exists. And if these two are different, if suppose limit x tending to, or maybe I can call this as left hand limit now. So if left hand limit and right hand limit are not equal, okay, you are getting different number when x is approaching to a from different side, from left side and right side, then this means limit does not exist. Okay, the value of limit will exist only when these two are same, left hand and right hand limit are same. Also, once these two limits are same, then you can combine these two results. Left hand limit was 2, sorry, left hand limit was 4, left hand limit is 4, right hand limit is also 4. So, since these two limits are same, so you can combine these two and you can write that limit x tending to 2 f of x, this will be 4. Okay. Now, here we are not writing whether x is approaching to 2 from left or right, because the value of this limit is the same whether x is approaching to 2 from left side or right side. So, it is not necessary to write 2 minus or 2 plus. Limit x tending to 2 f of x is 4 whether x is approaching to 2 from left side and or right side. But if we were getting different numbers, okay, for example, say in some other problem, if say limit x tending to 2 minus f of x is say 2 and limit x tending to 2 plus f of x is say 3. So now you cannot write this thing that limit x tending to 2 f of x, this will be some number, because now the value of this limit will depend on whether x is approaching to 2 from left side or right side. Okay, because we are getting different number from different direction. So in this case, we will say that this limit does not exist. Okay, here you cannot write that limit x tending to 2 f of x is some fixed number, because that number will depend on whether we are approaching to 2 from left side or right side. Okay, so this was existence of limit. Now we will take some problems and we will see how to find whether limit exists or not. Okay, so now we have these three problems based on existence of limit. So we have learned that if left hand limit is equal to right hand limit, this implies limit exists. Okay, and if left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit, I mean this thing is obvious, if left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit, then limit does not exist. Okay, so for each one of these three cases, we have to find the left hand limit and right hand limit. And if those two are same, then limit will exist. If those two are different, then limit will not exist. So the first problem is limit x tending to 0 mod x by x. So here, if we want to calculate this left hand limit, then left hand limit means approaching to 0, but from left side. Okay, so this I will write as limit x tending to 0 minus mod x by x. Now remember that mod x is defined in this manner. Mod x is x if x is positive or 0. Okay, if you have any positive number, then you can directly remove the mod sign. For example, suppose if I have this number 2, and since 2 is a positive number, we can directly remove the mod sign. But if x is negative number, and if you want to remove this mod sign, then you have to place one minus sign outside. Okay, this will be the case when x is negative. For example, if I have this number minus 2 and I want to remove this mod sign, then I have to write a minus sign outside, because if x is negative, then minus x will be positive, right? So here also, now 0 minus is a negative number. See, this is your coordinate, this is your number line. You have 0 here. If you are approaching to x from left side, extending to 0, see this 0 minus is nothing but a number very close to 0 but negative number. Okay, so this number is 0 minus. I mean, this is not a correct way of writing this, because this is concept approaching to, not equal to any fixed number. So, but just to explain the idea, this 0 minus is a number very close to 0 but with minus sign. So 0.000, many more zeros, and then 1. Okay, so this is 0 minus. So here if I want to remove this mod sign and this x is a negative number, then we have to write one minus sign here. So this means we can write this as limit x tending to 0 minus, and if I want to remove this mod sign, then I have to write one minus sign here. So minus x by x. Okay, now these two will cancel and this will give us minus 1. So this means if you have a number very close to 0, then mod x by x will be minus 1. Okay, and this was obvious, because forget about all these things. Suppose if I simply substitute this number, then what I will get? Just to explain the idea, suppose if in place of x I write minus 0.1, okay, so the value of this mod x by x, this will be say mod of minus 0.001 and this divided by minus 0.001. So you can see that this numerator will become positive, denominator is negative, and both of these are same number, so this will give us minus 1. Okay, so this means left hand limit for mod x by x at x equals to 0 is minus 1. Next we need to calculate a right hand limit. Right hand limit will mean limit x tending to 0 plus mod x by x. Now 0 plus means a number very close to 0 but positive number. This is your 0 plus. So if I want to remove this mod sign here, then since x is positive number, you can directly remove the mod sign. So you can write this as x by x. These two will cancel, you will get plus 1. Again you can think that if I had plus sign here, then mod x by x, this will give us plus 1, because now these two numbers are exactly same. Mod x will give us positive outcome, x is also positive, so the ratio will be 1. But here mod x will give us positive number, x is negative number, so ratio becomes minus 1. Okay, so here since left hand limit, which is minus 1, is not equal to right hand limit, because minus 1 is not equal to plus 1. So since left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit, this means limit does not exist. Okay, so this was one problem based on the existence of limit. Now we have these two problems. These are again very interesting problem, because with the help of these two examples, we'll learn one important concept. So our second problem is, we have to evaluate this limit x tending to 0, 1 by x. So first we are going to calculate this left hand limit. Left hand limit will be limit x tending to 0 minus 1 by x. So this will be 1 by 0 minus. Okay. Now here again, 1 by 0 minus means reciprocal of a number very close to 0, but this number is negative number. Okay, think of this 0 minus as this number, minus 0.001, and 0 plus as plus 0.001. Okay, these two numbers. So again it is not correct to write in this manner, but to explain the idea I am writing this thing. So suppose if I have to find the value of this 1 by x when x is approaching to 0 minus, so this means you have to take reciprocal of this number. So if you take reciprocal, then you will get a very large number but with negative sign. Okay, because 0 minus is a negative number. So 1 by 0 minus, this will be nothing but minus infinity. So left hand limit is minus infinity. Now comes right hand limit. So right hand limit will be limit x tending to 0 plus 1 by x. So now this will be 1 by 0 plus. 1 by 0 plus means now you have to take the reciprocal of this number 0 plus. So if you take a reciprocal of a number close to 0, then you will get a very large positive, very large number, and since this is positive number, it will be a large positive number. So 1 by 0 minus is minus infinity, 1 by 0 plus, this will be plus infinity. Okay, so again, since left hand limit is minus infinity, right hand limit is plus infinity, left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit, this means limit does not exist. Okay, now if you see, if you want to see this thing graphically, then we all know how to draw the graph of this function y equals to 1 by x. This y equals to 1 by x is nothing but rectangular hyperbola. Okay, this we have seen in our earlier discussion when we were talking about symmetry, about the line y equals to x. So this was our graph of the function y equals to 1 by x. So here you can see that we had to evaluate the limit at x equals to 0. So if you are approaching to 0 from left side, the value of y is approaching to minus infinity, right? When x is very close to 0, y is minus infinity. So this means your left hand limit was minus infinity. And when you are approaching to 0 from right side, the value of y is approaching to plus infinity, right? So on one side you are getting minus infinity, from other side you are getting plus infinity, and therefore here limit does not exist. okay, because the left hand limit and right hand limit are not same. So this was our second example. Now we are going to see our third example, and from these two examples, second and third, we will derive one important result. Okay, so our third example was this limit x tending to 0 1 by x square. Okay, now we need to evaluate, now we need to find whether this limit exists or not, and if it exists, then what is the value of limit. So here if I want to calculate left hand limit, then left hand limit will be, left hand limit will be limit x tending to 0 minus 1 by x square, right. So now this will be 1 by, and if I place x equals to 0 minus, then I will get 0 minus squared. Okay, now 0 minus is a negative number, this was our 0 minus, but if you square this, then you will get a positive number, right. And if number is very close to 0, then a square is also close to 0. So now your denominator is a number, is a positive number very close to 0, and therefore reciprocal will be plus infinity. Okay, so left hand limit is plus infinity. Now we can talk about this right hand limit. So right hand limit will be limit x tending to 0 plus 1 by x square. So this will give us 1 by 0 plus squared. Now 0 plus positive number, square positive number, but a very small number, very close to 0, reciprocal will be infinity. Okay, so now as you can see that this left hand limit is equal to right hand limit, and therefore limit exists. And what is the value of this limit? So we can write that this limit x tending to 0 1 by x square, this will be infinity. The reason is that whether you are approaching to 0 from left side or right side, you are getting the same value, plus infinity. So therefore here limit exists. And if you want to see this thing graphically, then if these were our coordinate axis, then this was our graph of function y equals to 1 by x square, right. This was our graph of y equals to 1 by x square. This graph we had seen in one problem, unbounded and unbounded function. So if you see carefully here, if we have to evaluate the limit at x equals to 0. At 0 the function is not defined. When we are approaching to 0 from left side or from right side, the value of y is approaching to same number plus infinity, right. Left hand limit is also plus infinity, right hand limit is also plus infinity. So therefore here we can say that this limit exists and the value of limit will be plus infinity. Now I have taken these two problems to explain the concept of limit, because many times people have this confusion that if I am getting plus or minus infinity in limit, then there must be something wrong. I mean, you must get some nice number like 2, 3, 4, 5 or some finite number in case of limit, but that is not correct. Here you can see that in first example, here limit does not exist, but the reason is not that we are getting plus or minus infinity. The reason is that we are getting different value for left hand and right hand limit. So therefore here limit does not exist. But in the second example, you can see that you are getting plus infinity and plus infinities for both left hand and right hand limit, and therefore here limit exists. Okay, the value of limit is infinity is perfectly valid answer. Only thing is that you should get either plus infinity or minus infinity, so for both left hand and right hand limit. If you are getting different value for left hand and right hand limit, then limit will not exist. So this was all about existence of limit. Now we will talk about indeterminate forms.
To get complete video lectures of GATE, IES and SSC JEE Mechanical Engineering branch, download our free application GATE Lectures for Mechanical from Play Store. To continue getting preparation related videos on YouTube, subscribe our channel along with